rolling, though the streams are swollen, keep them doggies rolling, right, through rain and wind and weather, hell-bent leather, wishing my gal was by my side. All the things I'm missing, good fiddles, love and kissing, are waiting at the end of my ride. Move 'em on, hit 'em up, hit 'em up, move 'em on, hit 'em up, rawhide. Cut 'em out, ride 'em in, cut 'em out, ride 'em in, rawhide.
Things that keep me up at night, besides hot flashes. But I'm bump. Anyway, therapy. One of my pet peeves. Yeah, therapy. Quite the profit-making industry these days, isn't it? Thank you, Oprah Generation. Thank you, Dr. Phil. Although Dr. Phil is tying it to science, which is making it closer to something that's, you know, tangible. Like, you can prove, like, what's wrong with the person, right? Whether it's like, sometimes he does what, the metal thing where they test for metals in your body and stuff like that, and do brain scans and all of that. And I think that's very telling and way closer to science. So he's doing a good job with that. But there's a lot of memes passed around, you know. And I don't know. My experience with therapy has been anything but productive. The two therapists that I would give credit for, most definitely, did two things. They identified the problem and they gave me information. We talked about that information, what was happening, and what I needed to do about it in terms of perhaps what boundaries to set, etc. That's what I got out of therapy a long time ago. Anything in between? Mm-mm. Nope. Nonsense. Perfect bullshit nonsense. Why? Well, because you go into therapy, you become the problem. You accept that you are the problem. When you know you're not the problem, if you know you're with a narcissist, you are not the problem. It's the narcissist. But that's never identified because doctors don't make house visits anymore, do they? So they, back in the old days, way back when, doctors, that's all they did was house calls. And there was a reason for that. Not just because no one could get to their office or anything like that. It wasn't like that at all. They came in to observe the house, to observe the diet, what people were eating, to observe the emotional environment of the family, to observe a lot of things. Yeah, they used to do that. That was a real doctor. Someone that really cared about health and well-being knew that they had to observe the environment. The problem is that the identified patient goes in, is identified as the problem, and nobody looks at the environment. In fact, if you're with a narcissistic abuser, not only are you going to get blamed, and they're going to be very good at blaming you, lying, whatever, behind your back with the therapist, but you've probably taken on some of that as well, not knowing that you're with a narcissist. So your therapy could go on for years and years and thousands of dollars later. And you could go into the philosophy. Again, it's a philosophy of wounded child, of wounded this and wounded that and that, that and the other thing. They're philosophies. Think about that. A lot of them do make sense. They make a whole lot of sense. The one that makes the most sense to me is objects relations. It really does. It makes sense. And you can really test for that as well in a lot of infants and children. Same with attachment theory. But the wrong assumption is that attachment has to do with mothering. It doesn't. It has to do with the child, not the mothering of the child. Believe me, I had two kids on the opposite ends of the spectrums. I was home, I did everything the same, and I indulged their different attachment issues. One wanted nothing to do with me and everyone else, and the other one I couldn't get off of me. He was Velcro baby. Honestly, he just was a bottomless pit of neediness. So, honestly, it was quite exhausting. But my philosophy when I was bringing up my children was, give them what they need now, and they won't need it later. Simple, right? Not when there's a narcissist involved. Oh, no, 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 no. So anyway, back to therapy and therapists. Why it doesn't work? Because you're going in at a very needy time, a very crisis time, especially if you're with a narcissist. And you take the chance that this therapist knows what they're talking about because they have a degree hanging on the wall. Whether it's real or not, who knows anymore, right? you have to do your background check, right? These days, I think I'm going to after that University of Chicago grad. Oh, I'm sure she graduated from it, but boy, was she a narcissist. Whew, big time. But you're dealing with, you're putting your mind in the hands of a person at your most vulnerable period, hoping that they're going to be professional. And so on. And some are. I'm not saying all aren't, but it passes. It's painful. It feels like it's never going to end, the crisis. You're desperate. You're lonely, perhaps. You're way into your addiction as a result of a recent trauma, maybe a rape or a beating or whatever, carjacking, who knows. They're there to hold your hand and be your parent. They want you to get into that dependency mode. I don't know. That's pretty scary to me. Once I started researching that, I went, you're going to reparent me, but you're not going to tell me that. No. You're going to manipulate me into that. Wow. Anyone who's ever been with a narcissist, you really want them fucking with your head like that and not telling you? Yeah, not me. Not to mention you're recently traumatized, perhaps, because you've been with a narcissist. Then there's the trauma bonding. Again, you see them as a stable, you know, parent figure. And when I read, and I forget which vlog it was, but something about you need therapy for 10 years. Can you imagine every week for 10 years? First of all, the cost of that. Second of all, the fucking time. 10 years? Seriously, does nobody have a grandmother anymore they can turn to? A wise, loving old grandmother? No, not these days. I don't think so. Anyway, another example of how therapy doesn't work. Rehab. Yeah, rehab was all the rage when it was the answer for tough love. I can't take this anymore, your addiction anymore, okay. And interventions, where everyone sits around and tells you everything that's wrong with you and why you need to go. Can you imagine how humiliating that is? I love you, but, gee, I don't know. The person with the addiction sure sounds like the fucking scapegoat to me in a narcissistic family. Doesn't it? Sure does to me. So they all say, let's send you to rehab and have somebody else fix you up so that you're nice and tidy and clean and perfect and you come back into the family, the lion's den. You don't cause us any problems. Because, see, your addiction was the problem. No, that wasn't the problem. The problem was the family. scary as it is, scapegoat, it's the family. So my point about rehab is then they, if you move down the timeline, well, why do you keep ending up in rehab the second time, the third time, the fourth time? Oh, because they'll tell you, oh, yes, it needs a few times depending on the, you know, the seriousness of the addiction and compulsions for it to kick in or something like that. No. It happens a second time, a third time, and a fourth time because it doesn't work. It's an industry. It's a profit industry. So they're going to make excuses for why they failed you for the second time, the third time, and the fourth time. Because they don't know what the fuck they're doing. They send you back into the lion's den. Because you weren't the problem. It was your family that was the problem. You needed to go no contact and never go back and never look back. I promise you. So therapy, it doesn't work for the same reasons. I want people to keep in mind too that just like the narcissist, people can get addicted to things like depression, anxiety. Yeah. Just like the narcissist gets addicted to fantasy life and can pump up the endorphins in their mind to give them a high, people can also get addicted to depression. Yeah. Believe it or not, sadness, procrastination, all sorts of things. For whatever reason, you have to find out what is behind it. Not a childhood issue, although it could be if you're still in your home, in the environment with the narcissist. Check your environment is what I'm saying. Check your environment, who's in it, all the assholes you need to get out. You'll feel a lot better. And as for therapy, well, like I said in the beginning, the only therapists, the two true blue therapists that really helped me, where I thought were really straightforward, direct, and to the point, were the ones who identified the problem that I described immediately, I mean, within the first session, and gave me and then recommended information. Here, read this. Here, read that. Here, read this. Tell me what you think. Does it resonate with you? Okay, now here's what you do. Try this, try that, try that. Sure as shit, they were right. Yep. These are things that keep me up at night. I really have a deep resounding dislike for therapists. I went to college. I know the kind of people that went into this shit. They had more problems. A lot of them were narcissists. Yeah. Can you imagine their eyes light up when they get someone with a never-ending insurance program from a good company? Yeah, it's a profit-making industry now. They're not doing it out of the goodness of their heart for you. Check your environment first. Check all the assholes in your life. Then do your goddamn best to get out of it because your sanity depends on it. These therapists aren't going to help you. No. They can give you ideas and information and what they call tools, right? Whatever. But that's about it. Then check yourself. Are you addicted to something? Because you can get addicted to emotions. You can get addicted to victimhood, just like the narcissist does. Just because the narcissist does it doesn't mean you can't do it too. Everybody has that in them. Everybody can do it. So, I think that's about it. Some things that keep me up at night. Hope that helps someone tonight. Peace out.
Keep moving, 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 though they're disapproving. Keep them doggies moving right. Don't try to understand them, just rope and throw and brand them. Soon we'll be living high and wide. My heart's calculating, my true love will be waiting. Be waiting at the end of my ride. Move 'em on, hit 'em up, hit 'em up, move 'em on, hit 'em up, raw high. Cut 'em out, ride 'em in, cut 'em out, ride 'em in, raw.